There is a great debate going on Twitter. Was that not a foul? You decide, Seth. I thought his body got into him a bit.
It was definitely a foul. The shooter has a right to land, and the defender, Doughty, he got into the body of the shooter, Kyle Guy, and that is a foul. You've got to call the foul. They've called it all season long. Quite honestly, they called it all throughout the NCAA tournament. That call was correct. Now that call at half court, the double dribble, the official absolutely kicked that call. That was right in front of him. You can pick up a fumble, but you cannot dribble a fumble. The game would have been over. They kicked the call on the double dribble.
Yeah, we're not done talking about this game, I'm certain. All right, how about a guy going to the line, making three straight free throws? I mean, you see NBA players who can't hit 60%. Mr. Indiana basketball knocked them all down.
Yeah, he did. And Kyle Guy, he's made big shots for Virginia. That three he made in the corner prior to getting fouled was as big as any shot he's made all season. Think about the Virginia team, the poise that they had down to push the ball up, well, not really push it up, but advance the ball. Kyle Guy came off that corner, baseline screen, knocked down that three, and then to step up to the line and make those three threes. He's an elite shooter. He's a world-class shooter. He's a kid, quite honestly, I would think, that dreamed about stepping to the line in a big moment and making free throws, and that's exactly what he did. He looked so confident, so relaxed. He stepped up the line. He made the plays he needed to make, but that was a double dribble at the half court. That was a kick call by the official. The game should have been over. Virginia advances. Now we'll find out who they're going to play.
All right. If not for the crazy stuff that happened at the end, we would be lauding what Auburn did. I mean, they looked done with about 5 minutes to go, and they just found a way to inch back. Pretty soon they got the lead.
Yeah, they were down 10 points with 5 minutes to go, and Virginia kind of took the air out of the ball even for them, had a bunch of empty possessions, and then Bryce Brown made back-to-back big threes where he made great reads off of down screens and flare screens and shot it, and they shot themselves back in the game. They got a little bit more aggressive, but Virginia just got too passive. They played too deep into the clock, and when you're Virginia, when you play deep into the clock, they usually stay with what they're doing. They went to some high ball screen stuff, and Auburn did a terrific job defensively of pushing them out and away, making them uncomfortable, which enabled Auburn to get back in the game. Auburn really, really had great poise at the end of that game, made enough plays to win the game. Unfortunately, they were unable to win the game.
All right, Seth, enjoy Minnesota. I don't think you're done talking about the first semifinal game. That is going to go into stoppage time. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks, buddy.